Okay, now in this video we'll analyze the differential amplifiers when there's a mismatch in the value of RD. So in the previous videos we have considered the differential amplifiers which are perfectly matched, meaning the dimensions of the transistors are same, the transconductance of the transistor is same, and we assume the value of load resistance RD has to be same. So let us find out, of course, by considering those matched pair of transistors, we have analyzed so many parameters like what is the single ended gain, what is the differential gain for a differential input or common input, and we also estimated what is the common mode rejection ratio when you're measuring it differentially and when you're measuring it in the single ended mode. So let us try to understand the impact of the mismatch in different parameters on the CMRR of the differential amplifier. So let us first consider if there is a mismatch in the value of RD, how does the circuit will respond. So let us consider the differential amplifier. So with a perfect matching in terms of W by L of the transistor, and we are considering there is a mismatch in only RD. So let this be RD, that is load resistance. Let this be RD plus there is some change in the resistance, that is delta RD. So delta RD is now the mismatch between the two load resistors. So let us first consider what is the impact of this delta RD if the input is differentially applied. So you can see, let us assume that Vin1 is equal to Vin2, has the same magnitude as VID by 2. In the sense, I will take Vin1 as VID by 2, whereas Vin2 will be minus VID by 2, so that it is differential but it is balanced in nature. So we know that the single ended output voltage, that is V01 for this particular input voltage of Vin1, so is given by so VID into GM RD by 2. So whereas V02 will be VID, of course it is, this is minus, so this will be plus here because it is input itself is minus, it is GM into RD plus delta RD by 2. Since the value of delta RD is very small, what we can consider this as almost equal to, of course this is actually GM into RD by 2 into VID. So because this delta RD is, since it is very small, so whatever multiplication you're going to have RD plus, even though if you consider there's a 10% change in the value of RD, so instead of writing it as 1.1, simply write it as 1 times RD zone. So of course if you find what is V02 minus V01 by VID, which happens to be the differential gain of the differential amplifier for a differential input, so this happens to GM into RD itself. So there is no much impact of this change in RD on the differentially measured differential input. When I say differentially measured, it is V02 minus V01. The input applied is also differential. We almost have the same gain for a differential amplifier even though there is a mismatch in your RD. So let us see what is this will have an impact on the common mode signal. So we just, of course, we're going to do the simulation also and just justify that, okay, whatever assumption, whatever writing that we are doing is almost same. But let us find out what is the impact of this mismatch in the resistances when I consider Vin1 is equal to Vin2 is equal to a common mode voltage. So we know that the output voltage V01 for a common mode input voltage is, it is, of course, we know that it is VCM multiplied by RD by 1 over GM plus 2 RSS. So let me write the RSS here. So this is RSS. So the expression for V01 for a common input voltage is given by GM divided by 1 over, sorry, RD divided by 1 over GM plus 2 RSS, which can be approximately written as, assuming this quantity as very less compared to 2 RSS, I can write it as VCM RD by 2 RSS. So this is the V01. Similarly, V02, let me write it as, of course, which will be on the same lines. You can see now this is, this is now again minus here. This is again minus, and it is minus of VCM RD by, of course, let me write it as 2RSS. Let us write, since you have a RD plus delta RD, let me write this delta RD here. Let us see the impact of this delta RD on V02 and, of course, the differentially measured common output. V02 minus V01 by VCM, so which is nothing but the gain of the amplifier for differentially measured common mode gain. It is now nothing but V02 by VCM minus V01 by VCM. So this was initially, of course, when both the RDs were same, we were getting this gain as equal to zero. But you can see now, since there is a mismatch in the value of RD, the value of ACD is a non-zero quantity. So I can find out what is that ACM now is, sorry, ACD, that is differentially measured common mode gain, is now equal to, if we can just find out, this will be equal to delta RD by 2RSS. So this was actually zero when there were perfect matching between RD and RD. So this ACD, which is now a non-zero quantity, will result in CMRR, which was supposed to be infinity, now it will become, which is nothing but ADD by ACD. When I say ADD by ACD, it is differentially measured common mode rejection ratio, is nothing but differentially measured output voltage of a differential input, differentially measured gain of a common input. So we know that this ADD is given by GM into RD, whereas this ACD is given by delta RD by 2RSS. Delta RD by 2RSS. If I just rewrite it and then right, what is CMRR? Actually, CMRR was infinity for a matched case. So this was actually equal to infinity in case of a matched RD values. Since the values are not matched now, so it is now ADD by ACD, which is now equal to GM into RD by RD by, of course, delta RD by 2RSS, which is now equal to, I will rewrite it as GM 2RSS RD by delta RD, RD by delta RD. So if you can have a look at this particular expression, the value of CMRR is not infinity now. Now it has gone to a value which is now finite. So let us try to find out so it is now, I can write it as this expression, I can write it as 2GM RSS divided by delta RD by RD. So this is the error. So what does this mean is, suppose this is actually CMRR, which is differentially measured, is given by 2GM into RSS by delta RD by RD. Suppose if this delta RD reduces to zero, if there is no mismatch in the resistance, if you can see this, the CMRR becomes CMRR will tend to infinity. So what is most important here is, if the value of mismatch is more and more, then CMRR will going to keep on reducing. Let us see the impact of this change in the value of RD of both the transistors. How does it impact CMRR? You can see now this is a perfectly matched RDs. So let us do the simulation, try to measure what is the output voltage when you have both common as well as the differential input. We found that there was no noise that is coming here because it is perfectly matched. let me run it now. Suppose if I run and see, you can see this is, there is no much error here. There is no much error here. Let me just go back here and then let me just okay, let me delete these things. Okay, this is 180. Now let me intentionally introduce an error of 10%. So 10% means let it be 550 ohm instead of 500 ohm. You just see the impact of that on the differentially measured output voltage. Can you see there is more error now? The error is more now. The error is more. In the previous case, we didn't have that much error. Suppose if I just make this further, let me just see, this is 150 and can see, let me just make this also 150. Let me make this 150. Okay, both the W values are same. So let me first make this 500 and verify what is the error. Can you see, is this looking almost perfect? Is almost perfect. Now let me introduce an error of, let me introduce an error of 10%, 550 here. See the impact of that. Let me just increase maybe another 600. See the impact of that on your. Can you see the error is now keep on increasing here? Suppose if the value of this is made 700, you can see I'm having these other values. Run it. Can you see the error is more now? So the ability of the receiver to reject the signal is keep on shrinking. Because shrinking means, okay, you could able to see the noise here. So noise is coming because your CMRR has reduced from infinite to a finite value. Why this is happening is because there is more and more mismatch between the two RDs. So RD one is 500, other is 700. Because of that mismatch, you can see there is a common signal which is being coming in your differential output also. Suppose just have a look at that. When I make it equal to 500, you can see the error is almost zero. Can you see this is, there is no much error. There is no much error here. So this way we can able to see the impact of the change in the value of RD. How does that going to impact the CMRR, which was actually infinity. Now it is becoming a finite value.